This is going to look at the centrifugation-flotation method for nematode extraction. We start out with a soil sample, about 1 cup, and we're going to empty the sample into the bucket. I'm going to put about 1 gallon of water. I need enough water to be able to mix the entire volume of soil. Next, I swirl it to make sure that everything is suspended. I don't see any big pieces or anything like that. There is some organic matter in there, and much of it is floating. Then I'll let it settle for about 60 seconds. This will give time for the sand to settle out of suspension. I decant the water into this stack of sieves. The upper sieve is 35 mesh, and the lower sieve is a 325 mesh. The larger the number of the sieve, the more openings per inch, and the smaller the opening. Here are a couple of pictures of the mesh, and you can see the larger 35 mesh and the very fine mesh of 325. Decanting will leave the sand particles in the bottom of the bucket. The upper sieve will hold back the larger particles and organic matter like leaves, twigs, and roots. By tapping the lower sieve and by gently shaking, the pores in the sieve mesh will open and water will pass through. By tapping it like a tambourine, the water will pass out of the sieve. What remains is fine sand, silt, and organic matter like small roots, nematodes, and VA, vesicular arbuscular mycorrhizal spores. Next, I'm going to wash this down and concentrate the material in one part of the sieve. Here I have a rack of centrifuge tubes that I'm going to transfer my sieve contents to. Water is added by using the wash bottle. The water causes the soil to flow, and we direct this into the tubes. The whole concept here is to collect as much of this material as possible. Try and place about equal amounts in each tube. Then I will add water to fill the tubes. This will help balance the centrifuge. The tubes are then placed into the centrifuge and we spin this for a few minutes. That will cause all of the material to move into the bottom of the tube. Then we take the tubes and discard the liquid from the top. Since the water has a density of 1 gram per mL, all of the soil particles and biologics will be in the bottom of the tube. Next, we take a sugar solution containing 454 grams of sugar per liter and squirt it into the tubes. Mix the tubes to make sure all of the soil is suspended. The density of the sugar solution is approximately 1.18 grams per ml, which will allow the biological material to float, but not the soil particles. The volume in the tube is then completed with sugar water. Next, the tubes are placed in the centrifuge and then spun for a few minutes. This time, the soil particles will pass through the sugar solution and form a pellet in the bottom of the tube. Since the organic component is less dense than the sugar solution, the nematodes, small roots, and VA mycorrhizal spores will float. After the centrifugation, the tubes are then decanted, this time into the 325 mesh sieve. This will allow the sugar water to drain. The wash bottle containing water is then used to remove any remaining sugar solution. Once the material is washed, this is then transferred to a clean dish. The dish can then be inspected using a dissecting scope. Any nematodes found can be transferred to a microscope slide for inspection.